Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can enable field history tracking in Salesforce. If you want to follow Salesforce video training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now, first I am opening Object Manager from Setup and searching for employee object on which we are going to apply field history tracking. So to enable field history tracking, you need to do three tasks. So first you need to click on this details and you need to check whether this track field history option is enabled or not. So on employee object, this is not enabled. So first we need to enable this option. So I clicked on edit. I'm scrolling down this option. So from optional features, I selected track field history. And I'm clicking on save. So this was the first step. Now second step, we need to set history tracking by clicking on this button. So this will open a page and where you can see all the fields related to the related to that object are available. So first let's read this description. So this field history is saying that this page allows you to select the fields you want to track on the employee history related list. So all the fields which you will be selecting from below, their changes will be available on the history related list. Further, it says whenever a user modifies any of the field selected below, the old and the new values are added to the history related list, as well as the date, time, nature of the change, and the user making the change will be reflected there. Then you need to note that multi-select pick list and large text field values are tracked as edited. Their old and new values are not recorded, right? So you can see this page is divided into two sections. First is saying track old and new values. So these fields are other than multi-select pick list and long text area. And in second section, you can see it is saying track changes only. So career objective field is available here. So it will be either multi-select pick list or long text area. So right now this is long text area. That's why it is available here. So now I'm selecting these options, these checkboxes as true and this also, and clicking on save. So I selected some of the fields so that we can track history for those. So this is the second option. Now third option is to set page layout. So in page layout, we need to add the related list. So I'm clicking on the related list. So here you can see employee history option is available. So you need to click this employee history and you need to drag and drop it. And if it is already available, then you don't need to set this, right? So history related list is available here. I'm clicking on save. Now I'm going to open my university app where this employee tab is available. So now we are going to change a particular record of employee so that we can check how history works. So I'm opening this record. So here various fields are available. And if we go to related list, so here you can see employee history related list is available. And right now it is not having any record. So if I click on details, let me open those fields which we are going to track. So here you can see five fields which will be tracking old and new values. So I'm going to change salary first. So its original value is 40,000. Now I'm making it as 50 and clicking on save. So let's see what happens in the related list. So here you can see date, time is available, field is salary. User who modified is Sanjay Gupta, original value 40,000 and new value is 50,000. So this way changes our track, right? So salary field we modified and we tracked its changes. Now I'm going to modify career objective. So if I move to details, So here career objective field is available. So I filled test career objective here. I am clicking on save, moving to related list. And here you can see date, time, field name, and user. Only four things are available. Original value and new values are not available because this career objective is a long text area field. So for multi-select pick list and long text area, it doesn't contain original and new values. It just track that this field has changed, right? Now let's see what happens when we change those fields which are not tracked here. So we are not tracking city. So let's change city. So country is India. So let me change country also, because country and city both are dependent pick list. So if country is USA, then it will show US related cities only. So I'm changing country as well as city and clicking on save and moving to related list. So here you will see country field is available. Its original value India and new value is USA, but city is not reflected here, right? So this way we can track field history for particular fields, and a separate related list is available here, which is tracking all the changes of particular fields which we selected in the field and relationship option. So here we can apply filter, refresh, and list view options. So you can do these changes as well as per the requirement. So I hope you understood how we can set history tracking for certain fields related to a particular object. So you can apply this for custom as well as standard object, and as per the requirement of your projects. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.